Last time on Total Stuff Left Island Season 2, it was a heck of an explosive battle in the dark with a nasty topping of bob bombs for a delicious challenge. Croc Rock and Drillbear settled their differences at last and won it for the troublesome twerps with some tactics beneath the ground. Meanwhile, conspiracies forming in the Rockin' Rockets after Dragalor accidentally impersonated Kranidos in a case of sudden betrayal. It was no contest and Kranidos got the shaft. Korin's also planning something with Dragalor, but what? We'll figure that out on this exciting episode of Total Stuff Left Island Season 2.
Dragalor, Korin, I was... Oh my!
Flygon! About time you showed up. Wanna bite?
No, I only came to ask about the challenge. Only to find you and Dragalor getting way too close for comfort.
I think someone's jealous.
Are you going to finish that?
Go right ahead. Flygon, I'm expecting an important guest. Can you go, shoo-shoo?
But we're in an alliance. Why can't...
Shoo! It's about time you showed up.
And why do you need my services?
Poor Dragalor here has grown big and strong.
So you're saying he's ready to power up?
Exactly right.
Very well. Stand back.
Have fun.
Wait, what? Power up? Wait, I don't...
That didn't feel too bad.
Wait. No, no. Something's happening.
Oh, my.
Forgive me, my friends! Forgive me!
Dragalor?
He's perfect!
I agree, Kamek, he's wonderful! Now, shoo!
Wait till Lord Bowser hears about this!
We're going to do great things, you and I! Alright, big guy! First one to jump over Squash wins!
First to jump over who?
Doki Doki!
And go!
Don't you dare!
Too late! Oh yeah! Made it!
Correction. Spike was slightly faster than you.
Yay!
Don't. You know, Spike, I wonder how you did it. Maybe it's because you don't have any arms?
Come on, Squash, we didn't hurt you. We just wanted to jump over you.
Fine, but don't let it happen again!
Wow. You know, there's two guys I've been meaning to get out of this game.
Oh? And that would be?
I'll tell you. Mighty Eagle and Newspaper. They're power players, and I can't trust them.
Well, I know how to push Newspaper's buttons, but Eagle's gonna be a real tough cookie.
My friend, are you needing something? Such a nice, juicy apple. Here.
I'd do anything to get him out. Even cheat.
Oh, wow.
Challenge time!
Okay. Well, we'll have to discuss this later.
So we will.
Murkrow's totally a wannabe. Wants to be a part of our alliance so bad and stay cool. And I plan to exploit that for all its worth.
You know, Rockets, you really gotta stop losing people for the merge. Anyway, it's time for the next challenge, which I have dubbed Nightmare.
Interesting. We'll be delving into the minds of our fellow contestants.
Nope.
Never mind.
For this challenge, I'll be introducing two brand new contestants, and they, alongside one member of your team, will be fighting it out with two knights.
Meowth, why are we bringing in new contestants all of a sudden?
Because I specifically said no one is going to be rejoining this game. So, I can bring in as many contestants as I want, and even eliminate two because we're bringing in new contestants to the game.
You know, we did this back on season one, and technically since two contestants are joining the game, there should be three contestants leaving, right?
Yeah, well I can't do math, so...
Besides, why get rid of three contestants right off the bat if one of them's going to our team and one's going to yours?
Alright, fair point. Speaking of those contestants, I should probably introduce them. Rocket Rockets, you get the advantage.
Is it cause we're the coolest? Cause you guys suck!
Oh, thanks. You guys get a walrus.
What?
His name is Jolly.
What are we supposed to do with him?
Well, if you don't want to lose, you gotta train it, silly.
Great.
And Troublesome Twerps, you get Broby.
Like to your Gabba Gabba show. I love that show. I mean, watching it fits the little ones, you know. Little cousins. They love the show, yeah.
Shut up!
Come on, bro. It's just a show.
Hey, you guys are my team. That's so cool. Hey, you guys like macaroni? Because I love macaroni. I love eating macaroni, especially because it gives a potty in my tummy. So yummy. So yummy.
Send him back. He's defective.
Nah.
I agree.
Holy!
Both contestants could never compare to Dragalor.
Wow!
Oh my god!
Oh man, he's bigger than me.
I see, Dracula, I've got a growth spurt. Great! Anyway, let me show you guys the knights you'll be fighting before we, get training.
Rock 'em, rock it, y'all get galleyed.
Greetings.
And Troublesome Twerps get Bishop.
That's right.
Each team also gets a giant knight to fight, too.
Anyway, let's get training. By the way, you can't eliminate Broby or Johnny. They are both invincible. That is a Stuff Loved Island rule, that no new contestants can be eliminated in that very same episode.
Dracula!
He's meaty, but doesn't have muscles like mine.
Fascinating as Dracula's growth may be, we need to focus on the challenge.
No.
Commoners must not approach the dragon, especially overgrown slugs!
Hey.
Let's focus on what we're supposed to be doing, the challenge.
Zorat?
Oh, but of course. Go ahead.
Zorat.
Ah, Unova Dweller, eh? I suppose.
Uncultured Svine, of course he is!
So, Jolly.
What are your powers? That didn't answer my question.
Guys, please. In order to speak to Jolly, we have to speak on his level, which is way down here on the floor. How do you put up with this guy?
Don't ask questions you aren't prepared to handle the answer to.
Yeah.
Do you know what he's saying?
Okay, this is stupid. I'm out of here.
Don't go! I know what he's saying! He says he knows how to headbutt people and eat a lot of clams.
Huh? You're serious? Okay, then I'll sit down.
Okay, Broby, what can you do?
So, I love macaroni, I love to eat macaroni, I love to smell macaroni, I love to be macaroni.
Okay, great, tell us something we don't know.
That macaroni can be put with cheese.
Yeah, I agree, you're annoying. But come on, man, I'm good at dancing, I'm good at singing about the party in my tummy, I'm all about foods, and I'm all about being a good friend, man.
Okay, well,
for the challenge, can you at least fight?
Oh no, man, I don't believe in violence, no.
Pacifist? Okay, fine, but what if someone took your macaroni?
Man, I'd just be real sad, man. I'd say, hey, don't do that. And then they'd take my macaroni, and then I'd have no macaroni.
But if we shared the macaroni...
He just says the same thing over and over and over and over. If he makes it past two episodes, I'm going to explode. I think the Shellosses were better than him, and they were in last season. They were just annoying.
If he is a pacifist, he can't fight. So instead, we pair him with someone who can fight.
Hmm? Like who?
Many people on our team are strong,
but I'm thinking we go with Fastener.
You're serious?
Yes. His claws are as sharp as steel.
It would make for a fair fight.
We have Luigi, Spike, Reese, Dracula, myself, Shantae. You pick Fastener?
He's tiny enough to break the enemy guard.
Alright, fine. You know what? I don't even care anymore.
Ever since Dracula grew, Flygon's acted a little strange. I wonder why. I won't be fighting you. But I must inquire on your armor. It's very nice. What's it made of?
Oh, well, young miss, you are the first person to actually compliment my armor in years.
Your ghosts?
Precisely that.
I think I'm in love.
Yes, thousands of years ago.
And you're made of uh-oh.
Yes, metal, of course. Despite being ghosts, our suits of armor are solid.
Ah, yes. Will you excuse me?
You know, it's strange. I didn't see him before we got here. I mean, he wasn't on the plane with me, and I'm the only suit of armor in the mansion.
Jolly says, bounce on your head!
This is stupid!
I can't even do that.
And I question these decisions.
This is really annoying!
Knowing Cody, though, I've been through worse.
I would, but I'd make an earthquake and feel like an inconvenience. I think I will go check on my ant friend instead.
Okay, Mighty, you do that.
What next, Cody?
Jolly says, roll like a ball.
Is this proper training? At least that I can do.
We'll have to monitor this carefully. Flygon! I noticed you're a little down. Is something up?
It's Corrin and Dracula.
You see, Dracula was overfed a number of gems, and using magic, he became a monster in minutes.
What?
And now Corrin's flaunting Dracula like a trophy. He can't even talk anymore.
Hey. If you ever feel like you need someone to talk to, I'm here for you every step of the way.
I'll explain everything to you if you... can promise to keep a secret.
Hey, I'm a half genie. Keeping secrets is kind of my thing.
Thank you. In that case, I'll tell you everything I know.
Hey, Cora.
What?
Do you think we could possibly use Dragular in the challenge? I mean, he's so big and strong.
No.
What? But why?
He doesn't feel like it.
But Dragular can make decisions for himself, right? I mean...
No, he can't. Now leave before he escorts you out painfully.
Corin, I really wonder...
Hey, watch it! We're not supposed to flail around running for our lives unless Jolly says so! Okay.
Yeah, no, I'm done.
Boys, I've been thinking. Where's the best place around here to get some good eating?
Well, sir, that's an easy one. We can get some fish at the lake.
You never fail to impress me, boys. Now, do us a favor. Now, what is that clanking noise?
It sounds like a suit of armor.
Perfect.
Thought I would arrive at the mansion, but I end up here on this pathetic island.
Holy.
Perfect. Fresh victims for the Divine Trinity.
Wait a moment, boys. Wait a moment. And that goes double for you, too.
And what's stopping me from consuming you, Teddy?
First of all, ma'am, the name is Lotso Huggin' Bear. And second of all, as tall as you may be, I do decree that there is a taller person on the island that you are interested in. And it ain't me, and it ain't my boys here, neither.
You don't say.
Follow me and I'll introduce you to the mighty eagle.
Sir, what are you doing? What are you trying to do?
Hush now, boys. I've got this one under control. Now, don't I?
I certainly agree. Whoa. But you better be speaking the truth.
Yes, ma'am.
Did we just fail as bodyguards for our boss?
No, I think he did that by himself. I mean, ugh.
Guys! There's two knights, right? Well, one of those knights isn't actually a knight. It's...
We know! Where is my ant friend? Ant? Ant? Oh, I hope I didn't overfeed him.
And there he is. Mighty Eagle's the strongest, most patient, and most steadfast contestant in the game.
Oh, he's perfect. I must analyze.
Well, of course you can.
Time's up!
I'm hurt! But of course, here.
Oh, thank you.
Are you here to help me find my ant friend?
Well, sadly, no. I was here to tell you it's going to be time for the challenge, but Meowth beat me to the punch, so here we are.
I see. And what is the knight doing here?
I think he's haunted.
Do tell Meowth that I'm going to be late. I don't think I'm going to be selected for this challenge anyways, and I need to find my ant friend.
By all means, friend. It warms my heart to do such a good deed. A good deed indeed. One that can lead you closer to elimination, that is.
Okay, everybody. So, have you decided on who you want to choose for your challenge?
We choose Fastener.
Well, you really are stupid.
Perhaps Dragula does not desire on fighting.
No, it's because Corin doesn't want him to fight.
Says who? You know, guys, it's no trouble. I can always fight.
We are picking Fastener.
What?
Fastener.
Hey man, even everybody else doesn't think so. I still believe in you, because you are awesome. You know that? You're a cool guy. Okay, man, okay.
And what about you, Rockets? We pick newspaper.
What? Cody, I am the least viable person for our team. Why not pick Fox or Zelda?
Heck, I'm sure Tentacool could probably do better than me.
Eh, he's not wrong.
Well, what do you say, Jolly? He says newspaper's got the bod for the job. Wait a minute. There's a giant bird that's missing from your team. Where's the mighty eagle?
Oh, he said he's gonna be looking for his little ant buddy, so he's gonna sit this one out.
And why should I believe-
Mr. Meowth, that ant that he's with means the world to him. I know he wouldn't miss a challenge. So if he's not here, it means his aunt is really missing.
Fine. But just this once, I'll let it slide. So, Rockets, you're going first.
Whoa!
Good luck, Jolly. Make Papa proud.
Wow, y'all really picked the worst possible choice. I mean, maybe Murkrow's the worst possible choice, but...
Hey!
Newspaper, Jolly, here's how the challenge works. You have to beat Gallade and the Knight within the time limit. And if you don't, or fly out of the arena, you will automatically lose.
However, if both of y'all succeed, the team with the quicker time wins.
Ready?
Thanks a lot, Coney.
And what can I say except... You're welcome.
And begin!
Uh-oh. Huh. Well, I still have my artillery, so...
Ha. Nice try.
Are you approaching me? You found my weak point.
Give up. There's no way you're gonna win.
Oh, my. Did his newspaper just rip?
It what?
Whoa.
Hey!
Oh, sir, this is highly unethical.
Try one of these!
Oh.
Wow, newspaper, that was fantastic. Too bad Jolly's not having a great time.
He's not what?
Oh, Jolly, for the...
Come here, you overgrown pile of blubber.
Congratulations, newspaper.
I knew you could do it, buddy.
Shut up.
Worth it.
Yes, Jolly, you did fine as well.
How will the twips respond?
Not too great, I know that much. Newspaper clobber.
As for the other night, I don't think we're going to be seeing them for a while.
Calculating our chances at victory, we are destined to lose.
Do try to make this interesting for us.
Yo, man, I'd hug you if I could, but you're too sharp, and you'd probably hurt me, and that would make all the macaroni come out of my tummy, and I do not want that.
My spear would like to hug you personally.
Oh, man, this is kind of scary, man.
This can only go so well.
Oh, Mighty, there you are. You found your friend?
Of course. Why wouldn't I?
All right, Mighty, just asking.
And begin.
Peace out!
Okay, man, I'm not gonna fight you. I'm not gonna fight you.
Stronger than he looks. I can't believe that pink pest would even try to fight. He's so puny.
Yeah, little shrimp don't stand a chance.
Yeah, I mean, he is.
Oh my god, an ant!
Huh?
I hate ants! I hate ants! Ah!
I feel nothing.
Hey, you know what? This ain't that bad.
No,
Eagle, stop it!
Ow, ow, ow.
Oh, man, I'm so dizzy.
Get off of me, you stupid ant!
Mighty, what is wrong with you?
That shouldn't count towards the challenge, I mean. Eagle really ruined everything here, you know?
Not entirely, because... Fastener already beat Bisharp in the air, and he was the primary target.
It does kind of help that Fastener beat Newspaper by 1 second, but then again, who's counting?
And the night wasn't even affected by the earthquake anyway, so...
Troublesome Twerps win, courtesy of Fastener!
Fastener, I couldn't be any more impressed.
So, Rockets, elimination, again, let's do it.
Wait, did I do that? I didn't mean to.
Useless giant stinko fangle, you pathetic worm!
What the heck happened this challenge?
Either something's not right in the eagle's mind, or something is completely different with him.
It doesn't take a genius to put two and two together and realize that's not the eagle. Despite the earthquake's and eruption, this challenge went rather adequately.
Must I draw you a picture?
What?
I'm bad, as bad can be.
Well, Mighty, what made you change your mind?
Today I learned something. I learned that I feel like a fool partaking in this pathetic game, and all those puny ants that stand before me must be squished accordingly.
But since you two are here, I'll let you in on the plan.
Okay, Mighty. Sure, sure.
We eliminate Newspaper by all means, and this is how you'll do it.
Wow, we gotta tell everybody fast.
Sir, where's our alliance? You mean Magnet, Shroom, and Murkrow. They're probably doing their own thing. Don't worry about it, boys.
Okay, sir. Sir, I'm concerned.
Do you think others are aware about our alliance?
No, don't worry, we'll be fine. Now, go on, do penguin-y things, like, I don't know, slide on the ice or something.
As you wish, sir.
Oh, finally, what took y'all so long?
Well, you'll have to forgive me for my girth. I'm huge, after all, and it isn't easy to traverse all this weight around.
Well, y'all better get out of here now before somebody sees us.
But of course.
Where could he be? Huh? My team, why are you here? Did we lose?
Yeah, Mighty. We lost.
No thanks to you!
Oh, of course, I'm sorry. I should have partook in the challenge, and I would have helped you and win, but... Of course, I'm still looking for my ant friend.
Relax, everybody. He had more important things to worry about, okay?
Thank you, Lotso. Thank you.
Mighty, you were there at the challenge. It's just... You weren't acting like yourself.
What? I was looking for my aunt the whole time. What are you talking about?
No, Mighty. You were being a filthy, stinking bad guy.
Slander! Slander!
Shut up, everybody. It's time for elimination. Everybody's already cast their votes except for you, Eagle. Get in there and vote.
Whoa!
But as for the rest of you, you've all cast your votes and made your decisions. So once I call your name, come on up, for you are safe. And the one who I do not call will be automatically eliminated and out of the game forever. And of course, Jolly, your first day, you're automatically safe. Next up is Tentacool.
Oh boy, yay.
Red Bird, Blotso, Magnet Shroom, Fox, Zelda, Penguin Yay 1, Penguin Yay 2, and Murkrow.
I'm here. What did...
Eagle, you're safe too.
What? Okay. Oh!
Uh-oh!
Oh, thanks, guys. Thanks for the appreciation. Me going all the way only to lose.
Shush. One of you got no votes. The other got 12. And even if Eagle's vote comes in, it does not matter. Because Cody is safe. And Newspaper is out at 12 votes.
What? How does that make sense? 12 votes? You all voted for me?
Did you say 12?
Yeah, I did. Why?
That's impossible. I didn't put my name down.
And I know I wouldn't put Newspaper's name down. I'd put my own down before him, and I'd even put my pants and my shoes before I put Newspaper's name down. Okay, so what are you trying to say?
I'm saying the votes were sabotage, and I want a recap.
I also didn't put Newspaper's name down.
Yeah, same here. I didn't put his name down.
Uh-oh.
not over here.
Uh-uh. No, sir.
Well, my vote was for Murkrow, if that makes any sense.
Hey!
Nope.
Nope.
Well, glad to see I'm appreciated, but...
But who sabotaged the votes?
Hey, meow. Y'all know the confessional will tell you who sabotaged the votes, right?
That's right. Roll the footage.
I'm not sure who to vote for. I don't know what to say in this. I suppose Coney?
Thanks, Coney. You made my brain hurt. I'm voting for you.
I'm not sure who Lotso's gonna vote for, but I'm gonna vote for the Eagle. Mighty, what is wrong with you? I don't know. Coney, I guess. I mean...
You know, Coney, you may be an idiot, but you did help me get my confidence, and you made me angry enough to win, so, thanks. I'm gonna vote for the Eagle.
Wow, Eagle, this sure was a good idea. A bunch of fake votes instead of the real votes. Evil! I love it! Squawk!
That answers that.
So, guys, let's all go back and pretend this never happened and vote out the Eagle, right? Right?
Murkrow?
Yeah?
If the footage serves me correctly, did you tamper the votes?
Sure did.
So you rigged the votes so Newspaper would lose, right?
Yeah, sure. I did it. Yeah. And we're gonna go back and pretend like nothing happened, right?
Actually, Murkrow, you are disqualified.
What?
Yeah, because you admitted to cheating, and that is no bueno. Murkrow, you are eliminated from the game.
What?
Besides, we need to eliminate two contestants anyway, and you are perfect.
What? Oh, but the Eagle's the one who told me!
I did no such thing!
It's true, I saw it!
Are you saying you cheated too?
What? No, I didn't cheat, I didn't tamely vote.
Now, thanks, Magnus Shroom! Some friend!
The evidence is pretty clear, Meowth. Get him out of our sight.
Kirakichu?
Gladly.
Hey, put me down! Put me down!
Any last words?
Well,
oh, wait, I don't care.
Okay, everybody, we gotta re-vote because Murkrow cheated, so...
Meowth. I know it's none of my business, but, I found this guy outside.
My aunt! Oh! My little friend.
Torrance?
Yes, I'm here. I'm here.
Mighty.
I'm just glad to have finally found you.
Torrance.
I don't know who we saw today, but the Eagle scene was not Mighty.
So, now that you're back...
Vote for me.
What?
You heard me, Red, and everyone else. Vote for me.
But why? I mean, you're not evil, Mighty.
I know that. But at the same time, my aunt friend is suffering immensely because of my careless actions. It's not about what if. It's about what I could have done. Maybe I could have been quicker, and I could have saved my aunt friend from sure destruction. But instead, I was too slow. And if I can't protect the ones I care for the most, well... There's no point in me being in the game anymore.
Mighty, perhaps we misjudged you all this time. Don't have to tell me twice. I don't know about y'all, but I'm gonna go cast my vote.
Yeah. Sorry, Mighty.
I'm gonna miss you, Mighty.
I know this isn't your fault.
Hug the big guy, everybody.
Well, hugging's what Lotso's do best. Come here now.
Right, sir.
I do not hug.
Okay, maybe just this once. It's fine.
Don't worry, big guy.
We know you didn't do it.
This almost touches my heart. But with only one vote against him, Mighty, you are eliminated.
See you later, big guy. Wouldn't want to be ya.
Keep up that attitude and we'll vote for you instead.
Well, I mean, bye, Mighty. Nice knowing you, big guy. Literally, you were the only person I put down because nobody else wanted to vote. So, yeah, bye-bye.
Come on, big guy, let's go.
Wait, my aunt!
All right, fine. Come here. Florent, intern, take this one to the Mighty Eagle's nest.
But of course, sir.
All right, Eagle, got any last words?
Yes. I've let down America, I've let down Finland, I've let down the kingdom. But most importantly, I've let down the ones I've loved. And I'm going to work as hard as I can to repair the mistakes I've made. Farewell.
And like that, the Mighty Eagle has left the game. What'll happen on the next episode of Total Stuff Loved Island? Why is Dragular so big? And what exactly is the team gonna do without their biggest player? Find out all this and more on the next exciting episode of Total Stuff Fluffed Island.
Y'all almost got me caught today, you know that?
But you're fortunate that your teammates are incompetent.
Well, yeah, I wouldn't say that.
Except for the princess. Huh? Watch out for her. She is smarter than anyone else in the game. But you've helped me acquire all of my data. My services are no longer needed. Farewell.
Y'all aren't sticking around with me?
You would be found out too easily. Goodbye.
Ho-ho, don't matter none. I got this game in the palm of my hand.
I'm not finished. You should have gotten a snack.
Sit up.
Ouch.
Whoa! I grabbed the wrong guy.
My bad.